In Illinois' response to COVID-19, I have said since the beginning that we are operating with a specific focus on our residents who are most vulnerable to the effects of this virus. Our seniors, our immunocompromised individuals, and people who have pre-existing conditions. And because of decades of disparities in healthcare access and delivery, we've seen the worst effects of this pandemic fall disproportionately upon the backs of the communities of color in our state. That's especially true in our Black communities, our Native American communities, and our Latinx communities. Jaime DiPaolo and Dr. Del Rios have joined our daily public update because I want to bring more attention to the work all of us are doing to support our more vulnerable populations, especially the Latinx community, which is now testing positive for COVID-19 at the highest rate of any demographic group in Illinois. Although nearly half of those who have been tested did not fill out their demographic information, of those who did, 7.6% self-identified as Hispanic. Of these more than 26,000 individuals, nearly 16,000 of them have tested positive for COVID-19. That's a positivity rate of 60%. That's nearly three times our state average. As a point of comparison, for the half of people who left their race blank on their forms, about 18,000 tested positive for the virus. That's 10%. We don't know what portion of those unknowns might also qualify as Hispanic or Latinx, but what we do know is that our data from the start until today shines a concerning spotlight on which of our residents are most likely to get sick from COVID-19. Decades of institutional inequities and obstacles for members of our Latinx communities are now amplified in this pandemic. And while we can't fix generations of history in the span of a few months, we must advance equity in our public health response today, everywhere and anywhere we can. My administration has made it a priority to enter into testing partnerships in as many areas around the state as possible, with a focus on communities home to significant populations who are more vulnerable to this virus. We now have over 200 public testing sites in Illinois, a third of which are located in communities with a significant Latinx population, measured here as greater than or equal to 17%, which is the Latino population number statewide. The reason many of our partners in Latinx communities have been chosen is not just for their locations, but also their accessibility to other services, particularly language services.